A question you guys always asked was, how do I stream from my mobile phone and what app do you use and what was my streaming setup? Now I will answer all these questions in this video, so without wasting much time, let's get started. So let me explain you the process how we do it. First, we will mirror the thing that's there on our phone to our PC, and then you'd use an encoder to stream it out. So the first thing is mirroring the content on our phone to our PC. Now for that, you're going to need two applications, one on your laptop or PC and one on your phone. Now the application name is A-Power Mirror. You need that app. The link for the app is there in the description. You can go and check that out, and how to install it on PC, I've already shown you. So let's see. Okay guys, so I'm going to show you how to set up this on your PC, set up the application on your PC. It's really simple. Go to Google, search A-Power Mirror. Enter. Guys, check the spelling, by the way, okay? And see the first link, go there. By the way, it works both for iPhone and Android, so it's pretty amazing. Anyways, so here you see download now option. You just need to tap on that and it will start downloading. So I've already actually downloaded the application. See, it's showing you this pop-up. So it's 79.2 MB, so you can easily download it. I've already downloaded, so I won't download it again, but I will set it up for you. So this is the setup settings. We'll choose English. We'll go next. We accept the agreement. Yeah, okay. We'll select Drive C. Next, install. And yeah, now it's installing. So it's really simple. It's not that difficult. So it will install in Emodia. We are finished. Okay. So here is the icon, and it will of course auto launch. So as you can see, this application has two options, Wi-Fi connection and USB connection. So basically you can mirror everything on your phone on the computer screen, either through Wi-Fi or through USB. Now through Wi-Fi, your both PC as well as your phone should be connected to the same Wi-Fi. And for USB, you can easily connect it through USB. And I will show you both the procedures, so don't worry about it, okay? Alright, so I've already opened the A-Power Mirror app in my mobile phone. So this is how it looks. You can download it directly from Google Play, or you can directly download it from the link given in the description down below. Now open the A-Power Mirror app in your PC as well. Now tap here on the mobile phone, and now you can see it will detect. So if it is not detecting, tap on redetect and it will search, and it will automatically detect your PC. So as you can see, it has already detected my PC. I will just tap here. So we have three different options. We have computer screen mirroring. Through this, we can actually mirror the computer screen on our mobile phone, PowerPoint remote control, and finally the thing in which we are interested, phone screen mirroring. So we're gonna tap on phone screen mirroring. As you can see, start now option comes. Tap on start now on your mobile phone. And there you see, it's mirroring everything that's in your phone on your PC. It's really simple. So let's open PES because we all play this game so much. Alright, so as you can see, this will clearly mirror everything that's on your phone to your computer screen. Now there's another option under Wi-Fi connection, and that is through QR code. Now how to use that? It's really simple. First, click on this and you get this QR code. Now tap on the QR code and you basically just scan this QR code. That's it, and there you go. Now tap on start now and it will start mirroring everything that's there on your phone. So this is another method, and you can use it if somehow the Wi-Fi method, the normal Wi-Fi method, is not working, the auto detect method, it's not detecting your PC, then you can use this method. Now the third option is the USB option. So I prefer this one because there is lesser lag while mirroring, and overall the quality of the mirroring is better through the USB one. So I personally prefer this. However, if you're casually mirroring something or casually streaming something, then you can go for Wi-Fi. But if you're showing a gameplay or anything which involves a lot of movement and all, for that I think USB one is better. So let's start. First and foremost, there is certain requirements. First, you need to connect your phone to the PC through the USB cable. Second, you need to enable USB debugging on your phone. Now how to do that? It's really simple. Simply go to settings, go to about phone. Now you need to enable the developer option. For that, you need to tap 7 or 8 times in build number. So we're gonna do that, and there you see, give your password. Now you are a developer. Now go to developer options, See, you as you can see, it's there. USB debugging, just enable that. That is important in order to mirror through the USB connections. So tap on OK. As you can see, it will show a message. It will also show a similar message on the PC. Now tap on OK and select Android here on PC. And as you can see, it's already loading. So as you can see, it's showing start now. Just tap on start now and it will start mirroring everything that's there on your mobile phone. So these were the three ways in which we can mirror it. And now I'll show you the other things as well which are required, the various customizations in this app that you can do. So let's get started. So first and foremost is this setting. So you can go to setting, you can choose various display settings like the resolution and all. You can change the resolutions if you want. You can also change the FPS. You can choose 30 FPS, you can choose 60 FPS, you can choose the render mode, the UI style if you want dark, if you want light. It's just based on your personal preference. You can also go to general settings and there's various options that you can choose. You can again go back to capturing settings. And these are the various, the video format as well, you can customize that as well. So there are various things that you can do. Now that you have done that, now it's time to set the encoder. So I personally use Streamlab OBS or OBS, you can use anyone. I use both, but let's see the whole procedure in Streamlab OBS. So I will open Streamlab OBS, under sources, I will click on plus, and then go to window capture, add sources, add new sources, and then under window, go to APower Mirror Main, and done, and there you go. This is how you can stream anything that's there on mobile. You can stream any mobile game like PUBG, PES or anything. Alright, now after this you just need to go and tap on go live and you can stream anything you want. So that was it guys, and I personally love this app because I think this is the best app to mirror. I've used many other applications and I can tell you from my personal experience that this is the most reliable one, and also this causes the least lag, especially if you connect it through the USB. There is very minimal lag, so if you're streaming games like PUBG or PES where there is lot of movement and FPS and all is there, it's really important that the lag while mirroring should be as less as possible, and this is I think the best app. As you can see, it causes really less lag, so it's the best app and I highly recommend you to download and use it. Okay, so that was it guys, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.